Hello students, in this video 12th standard computer science unit 2 chapter 5 python. In previous video you have learned the python input and output function and scripting mode in python concept. So now we will discuss about another concept like tokens. So in your book 5.7 tokens. It's very important concept in this chapter. It's a 5-mark question. So what is mean by tokens? So token means Python breaks each logical line into a sequence of elementary lexical components is known as tokens. In Python, breaks each logical line, each the programming coding section, okay? Python breaks each logical line into a sequence of elementary lexical component is known as tokens. White space separation is necessary between tokens, identifiers or keyword. If you want to creating any other space, we have to using the concept like tokens or identifiers or keywords. So what are the types of tokens in Python? How many types in the token? So there are 5 types of tokens like identifiers, keywords, operators, delimiters and literals. So the types of tokens like, it's a 2-mark question. What are the types of tokens or what are the elements of token? Maybe it's named like elements. So what are the elements in token like? You have to write identifiers, keywords, operators, delimiters and literals. So let us see the expansion and explanation for the given tokens. Like first one, identifiers. An identifier is a name used to identify a variable, function, class, module or object. It's very important. So identifiers, what is mean by identifier? An identifier is a name. We have to use to identify the variable, function, class, module or object. An identifier must start with an alphabetic letter A to Z, capital A to Z or small a to Z or underscore. Like dear student, please note, if you create the identifier first, it must be start with alphabetical letter or underscore. Identifiers may be contain digit also like 0 to 9. Python identifiers are case sensitive. Uppercase and lowercase letters are distinct. And another one, it's important. Identifier must not to be a Python keyword. We cannot use the keyword in the Python. So Python does not allow punctuation character, such as percentage, dollar symbol, at symbol, like and the special character, it's not allow. The punctuation character means the special character Python does not allow. At the same time, it cannot be accept the keyword also. If you declare the identifier means you should start the starting alphabetical letter or underscore. Otherwise you have to using 0 to number because the Python is a case sensitive, like we have to using small letter or capital letter. Okay. It's like an another concept, like it's a disadvantage, like the Python must not be a Python keyword. It's not accept and allow, it does not allow the punctuation character, such as the special character, percentage, dollar, at symbol, as symbol, like and all. Okay. So how to declare the identifier? The example for the valid identifier. So already I told, identifier start begin alphabetical letter A to Z. So A to Z like sum. So S is the alphabetical letter, capital or small. So a capital or small means Python is a case sensitive. So we have to use small letter or capital letter. Total underscore mark. So underscore also accept identifier. Resistor number. So here num1. So num1 after the character you have to use any number. So this is the declaration for valid identifier. And invalid identifier 1 to name. Already I told identifier first must start with an alphabetical letter. So character la dhaan vandu adu start pannanum. Okay. So here start 1 to. So 1 to is a number, it cannot accept. At the here we have to using some special character. So here also not accept. And total minus mark. So here underscore, here using minus mark. So it cannot accept. And continue. So continue is one of the keyword in the Python. So these are not accept in Python identifier. So these are the invalid identifier. So these are invalid identifier. So like valid identifiers, like sum, total underscore marks, register number, here first letter capital letter, here small letter, and here using some number. Okay, here starting number it cannot accept. Here using special character it's not accept. Here also minus is a special character, not accept. And continue is keyword, so it cannot accept in the identifier. Can you understand, student? Yes. And next one, keyword. So what are the keywords in the Python? So please note down. Keywords are special word. Keywords are special word. It's a one mark question. Keywords are special or reserved word. Default away vandu declare pannirukanga Python program. Okay. So keywords are special words used by Python interpreter to recognize the structure of the program. So in your book 5.1 Python's keywords like false, class, finally, is, return, none, continue, for, lambda, dry, true, tough, from, non-local, while, and, del, global, not, with, as, elif, if, or, yield, assert, else, import, pass, break, except, in, rise. So these are the keywords in the Python. So these keywords cannot be allowed the identifier. So if you write a sum of keywords in Python, just you have to write any other like for, lambda, return, class, if, elif. So just you have to selected anyone. Okay, pass, import. So these are the keywords in Python. Just you have to memorize any 10. Just you have to try to memorize any 10 keywords in the Python. Okay. So keywords like a special words used by Python interpreter to recognize the structure of the program. So sum of keywords like continue, for, like lambda, not, and, if, elif, else, import, export, break, continue, like and all. Okay. And next concept, operators. So operators is very important. So there are different types of operators in the Python concept. In the computer programming language, operators are special symbol which represent computation, conditional, matching, etc. The value of an operator used is called operand. The value of an operator used is called operand. Operators are categorized as arithmetic, relational, logical, assignment, and conditional operator. So there are 5 types of operator. So just you have to note and mind. What are the different types of operator? Arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator, assignment operator, and conditional operator. So arithmetical operation means if you want to computation, calculation work, we have to using arithmetical operator. Relational operation, if you want to comparing, if you want to comparing or conditional checking, we have to using relational operator. At the same for logical section. And assignment, we have to assign some of the variable for given variable, we have to using the assignment operator. And conditional operator, we want to checking more than one conditional. We want to checking more than one conditional. We have to using that time the conditional operator. Okay. So the like the computer programming language operators are special symbol which represent computation, conditional, and matching. The value of an operator used is called operand. So the different type of operators like arithmetic, relational, logical, assignment, and conditional operators. Value and variables when used with operator are known as operand. So it's a one more question. Value and variables when used with operator are known as operand. So first one, arithmetical operator. So arithmetical operators like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulation, exponent, and floor division. So here one example, I considered a equal 100 and b equal 10. So evaluate the following expression. Addition means you have to add a plus b like 110. Subtraction, a minus b like 100 minus 10, 90. Multiplication, 100 into 10, we get the answer 1000. Division like a division by b. So like here we have to note down division and floor division. So division means we have to get the value, quotient value. So 100 divided by 10 like 10 tens are. So here and the quotient value we have to take. And modulus like a divided a modulus 30. What is the value in 100? A. So what is the value in a 100? So 100 modulus in 30. So like. So see. And the next one, modulus. So modulus a modulus 30. What is the value in a 100? So 100 modulus 30. What is the value we got to get the remainder like? The 10. So modulus means we have to get the remainder value. Okay. And the exponent is the power of value. Exponent is power of value. A double star 2 like what is the value in A 100? So 100 into 100. We get the answer 10,000. And the floor division. So floor division we have to get the quotient value. So like A floor division 30. What is the value in A 100? So 100 floor division 30. So how many 30s are in 100? 3. 3 30s are 90. So answer 3. So 3 is the quotient value. Modulus means we have to get the remainder value. Modulus means we have to get remainder value. And floor division means we have to get the quotient value. So do you understand the arithmetical operation? So arithmetical operation we have to using the calculation process. Okay. And the next one, relational operator. Next one, relational operation. So relational operator like equal, greater than or equal, less than or equal, not equal. Like A equal 100, B equal 30. So A equal B, it's a correct? No, it's a false. And A greater than B, this condition is true. Am I correct? A is 100 greater than 35. So we have to get true. A less than B, 100 is less than of 35? No, so you have to write false. And A greater than or equal B, A greater than or equal B. Like Aங்கிறது 100 Bஐ விட ஈக்குவலா இருக்கணும் அட் தி சேம் டைம் Bஐ விட பெருசாவும் இருக்கணும் லைக் இங்க வந்து என்ன அப்படினா Bஐ விட பெருசா இருக்கு சோ அதனால வந்து என்னது ட்ரூவா தான் எடுத்துக்கணும் ஓகே அண்ட் ஹியர் A less than or equal to B Aங்கிற வேல்யூ வந்து பெருசா தான் இருக்கு சோ இட்ஸ் a false A not equal B சோ திஸ் இஸ் தி கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர் பிகாஸ் A இஸ் 100 வேல்யூ B இஸ் 35 சோ திஸ் இஸ் நாட் ஈக்குவல் சோ வி ஹேவ் டு ரைட் ட்ரூ Can you understand, student? Yes. And next one. So, just you have to mind the what are the operators we have to using in relational operator. What are the operator we have to use in relational operator? Equal, less than, greater than, greater than or equal, less than or equal, not equal. What are the operator we have to use in arithmetical operator? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulation, and exponent and floor division. Okay. And the next one, logical operator. So logical operator, like we have to use OR and NOT. Already you know the basic concept, like fundamental logical unit. So OR means any other one, we have to get the answer true, and both are true. And NOT means like true or false. Like A 95, B is 35. Evaluate the following expression: A greater than B or A equal B. It's a true. Anyone is correct. First one, A greater than B or A equal B. A equal B is a false. Okay, but A greater than B is true. So R ல ஏதாவது ஒரு கண்டிஷன் ட்ரூவா இருந்தாலே நம்ம எடுத்துக்கலாம். ஓகேவா? அதனால தான் இங்க வந்து ட்ரூ கொடுத்திருக்காங்க. அண்ட் அண்ட்ங்கிறது என்னது, ரெண்டுமே வந்து சமமா இருக்கணும். ஏ கிரேட்டர் தென் பியும் இருக்கணும், அட் த சேம் டைம் ஏயோட வேல்யூ பிக்கு ஈக்குவலாகவும் இருக்கணும். பட் ஹியர் நாட் கரெக்ட். ஓகே, திஸ் கண்டிஷன் ட்ரூ, திஸ் கண்டிஷன் ஃபால்ஸ். ஸோ லைக் இன் அண்ட் ஆப்ரேஷன் ஒன் zero, that means we have to get the answer zero. So zero means false. Okay, and not A greater than B. A greater than B is not nu sollirukanga. Adhaadu A vandu perusa irukirathu illa abdingiratha sollirukanga. Not A greater than B, so this is false, not true. Appadi thane pa, not true. A greater than B. A, what is the value in A? 97 and 35. இது வந்து கரெக்ட் இல்லைன்னு சொல்றாங்க. அப்படியா? இது வந்து கரெக்ட் தான், பட் ஆனா இது இல்லைங்கறத இங்க நாட்னு கொடுத்திருக்காங்க. சோ அதனாலதான் இந்த ஸ்டேட்மெண்டே வந்து ஃபால்ஸ்னு சொல்றாங்க. சோ இட்ஸ் அ நாட் ட்ரூ. ஓகே, அண்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் அசைன்மெண்ட் ஆபரேட்டர். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் அசைன்மெண்ட் ஆபரேட்டர். சோ அசைன்மெண்ட் ஆபரேட்டர் assign right side operand to the left variable. So we have to use the assignment symbol equal. We have to use the assignment symbol like equal. So right side operand, the value right side operand to the left variable. So here x equal 10. So 10 ngradhu value, right side value. In the value enga pay store aagudhu, x ngra left side variable store aagudhu. And here B is left side variable and computer is one of the value. So computer அப்படிங்கிற இந்த வேல்யூ லெப்ட் சைடு இருக்கக்கூடிய வேரியபிள் B ல வந்து அசைன் ஆகுது. So that is the meaning. Okay. So here we have to using some operators like plus equal, minus equal, and multiply equal and division equal. So addition equal means added, assign back the result to left operator. So here we have to assume x equal 10 and x equal to 30. So what is the meaning? X plus equal 20. X plus equal 20. So x plus equal, that means x equal x plus 20. What is the value already in x? 10. So 10 plus 20 like 30. 10 plus 20 like 30. So like 30. And subtraction x minus 25. So x minus equal 5 means what is the value in x? Minus 5. The value in x we have to minus the 5. Okay. Like here now the value 30 is the assigned in x. Okay. So x minus 5. 30 minus 5 like 25. Okay. So first we have to assign 10. After the x value 30, here changed. Okay, 10 plus 20 30. So now the value in x is 30. So 30 minus 5 25, and 25. But now the value of x is 25. Okay, so 25 multiply 5. 25 multiply 5, we get the answer 125. And here what is the value in x? 125. Divided by 2. 125 divided by 2. So please note. So 125 divided by 2. So just you have to divide the number. 1 2 is 2. 6 2s are 6 2s are 12, 2 2s are 4, remaining 1. So 0 add panna abdina, 5 2s are 10. So we get the answer 62.5. Are you clear? So what is the value in x? 125. Here you have to assign x divided equal 10. That means x oda value la x la enna value irukko adha 2 ala divide pannanum. So what is the value in x? 125. So 125 divided by 2, we get the answer 62.5. So the answer is 62.5. Are you clear, student? First value in x is 10. So here you have to add 20. X plus equal 20. So I x value 30 changed. And here x minus equal 5 means x order value la minus subtract panna solranga 5. So 30 minus 5 25. And now the x value is 25. The 25 oda enna pandranga 5 multiply panna solranga. So we get the answer 125. So the 125 2 ala divide panna solranga. So we get the answer 62.5. Are you clear? Yeah, so this is the concept for assignment operator. So just you have to note the assignment operator. Okay. And next one. The next concept like conditional operator. So the what is the another name of conditional operator? Like ternary operators. So conditional operators means ternary operators. So ternary operator is also known as conditional operator that evaluates something based on a condition being true or false. Condition true or false. It simply allows testing a condition in a single line, replacing the multi-line if else, making the code compact. So the syntax, the conditional operator is like variable name on true, if text expression, else on false. So please note down the syntax of the conditional operator. First one, variable name on true. If the condition expression true means before it will be explained, false else ngiradhu the false section means after the value it will be display. Okay, so here one example here this is the true section and 70 is the false section. Okay, condition being here, if 49 less than 50 means before what is the value is here it will be display. So min equal to 50, it's storing for the variable min. Okay, and min 50, if less 49 greater than 50. So here please note I will explain in Tamil. The students, in the conditional operator processing, what's the value it will be stored on the left side variable. Okay, so here two values are given on true and on false. So the expression means true. If the test expression true means before the value is stored on the variable, the text expression false means else part. False means after the value it will be stored the variable. Okay, so here variable name min, here 50. If the condition 49 less than 50, this condition is true. So condition is true means 50 stored on min. Okay, so min value is 15. And next one, min equal 50 if 49 greater than 50 else 17 kuduthirukanga. So this condition, what is the value stored in min? So this condition is false. So false means else part. What is the value in else? 70. So 70 it will be stored on the variable min. Okay, so I will explain one program after that. And the next two concepts. So the conditional operator is also called a ternary operator. It is based on working the condition based true or false. So condition true means true value stored. False means else part value is stored in the given variable. Okay. And next one, delimiters. So delimiters So what is the meaning of delimiters? So in Python uses the symbol and symbol combination as delimiters in expression list, dictionary and string. List, dictionary and string. So the sum of delimiters in Python, open and close parenthesis, open and close square bracket, open and close curly bracket, comma, colon, dot, apostrophe, equal, semicolon, plus equal, minus equal, like multiply, star equal, division equal, floor division equal, modulus equal, and equal, nor equal, not equal, like இது வந்து shift operand. So shift operand like left and right, இது exponent assignment. Okay va? And the next one, the fifth types of token like literal, the fifth types of token tokens like literal. So literal is a raw data given a variable or constant. Literal is a raw data. So one more question, literal is a raw data given a variable or constant. So there are three types of literal. First one, numeric, string and boolean. Numeric literal, string literal and boolean literal. So in the two mark question you have to write the answer like literal is a raw data given a variable or constant. So there are three types of literal like numeric, string and boolean. So first one, numeric literal. So numerical literals consist of digit or a re-immutable. So re-immutable like unchangeable. Numerical literals can be belong to three different numerical types like integer, float and complex. Integer, float and complex. So numerical literals, escape literals, boolean literals and string literals. So what are the string or boolean or escape? So given that, so string, so first one you know that string is a collection of word. String means collection of word. In Python a string literal is a sequence of character. Sequence of character like just you have to consider sequence. If a string, this is one of the sequence of character. S is one of the character, T is one of the character, R is one character, I one character, N one character, G one character. So the sequence of character like the string, it is surrounded by quotes. Surrounded by quotes. So please note, in Python, a string literal is a sequence of characters surrounded by quotes. In Python supports single quotes, double quotes and triple quotes for a string. Okay. We have to using three type of quotation mark. A character literal is a single character surrounded by single or double. If you use a single like A is one of the character. If you use in the program, you have to using single quote or double quote. Otherwise, the value within triple quotes is used to the give multi-line string literal. We want to creating more than two line. We want to creating more than two line string means we have to using three like triple quotes. Triple quotes. So that this is indicate triple quotes. We have to using the single or double quotes like single letter or any word. Okay. So multiple line we want to creating means that time we have to using triple quotes concept. So these are the concept in this string literal. So string is a sequence of characters surrounded by quotes. We have to using like single, double and triple quotes for the string. We have to using single letter means we have to using single quotes or double quotes. Multi line means we have to using the triple quotes concept. And here escape sequence. So escape in Python string, the backslash in backslash like in this symbol in your keyboard like above the enter key, above the enter key. Backslash means above the enter key and division means you have to using here. Okay, so backslash means above enter key. In Python string, the backslash is a special character also called the escape character. In Python string, the backslash is a special character. It is also called escape character. It is used to representing certain white space character. Like we have to creating the more than two space, backslash t or backslash n, or the backslash n we have to using new line, and t we have to creating tape space. White space means like five space we want to creating, that time we have to using backslash t. And backslash r is a carriage return. Backslash r is a carriage return. Okay, so escape sequence in Python we have to using backslash symbol. Backslash symbol. So here's backslash t, backslash n, and backslash r. So backslash t like we want to tape. So tape key. What is the uses of tape key? If you want to creating five character space. So five space we want to creating, that time we have to using tape key. So you using the tape concept, like you have to using the backslash t. And backslash n we want to creating the next line or new line. And backslash r is a carriage return. And then last concept in chapter 5, Python data types. In last concept 5.8, the last concept in chapter 5, Python data types. So data types is very important. All data values in Python are object, and each object or value has a type. Any other variable, any other values has a type. Python has built-in or fundamental types such as number, string, boolean, tuples, list, and dictionary. So we have to using the different types of data types in Python, like number data types, string data types, boolean data types, tuples concept, list, and dictionary. Okay, so here please note. Explain the data types in Python means you have to write these concept. All data values in Python are object, and each object or value has a type. Python has built-in or fundamental data types such as number, string, boolean, tuples, list, and dictionary. So here the number data type. Dear student, in 11th standard already you have to study the number system. So the different types of number system like binary, decimal, hexadecimal, octal, already you know that. Yes. So these type of concept you have to using in the Python. Like number data type. The built number object in Python support integer, floating point number, and the complex number. Integer data can be decimal or octal or hexadecimal. If we use the integer number, number means we have to using integer or floating or complex number. So complex mean floata or integer, both value we have to getting. Okay, if we use the integer data type concept means the integer can be decimal, octal, or hexadecimal. How can we understood the given number is integer, like octal or decimal or hexadecimal? So here the octal integer we have to using capital O, both uppercase and lowercase. Okay, and to denote octal digit, and hexadecimal integer use OX. Okay, so here in the number, like the integer we have to using decimal, octal, and hexadecimal. How can we understand given number is decimal or octal or hexadecimal? If the number is octal means we have to using O, before the number we have to using O. If the number is hexadecimal means we have to declare before the number OX. Decimal it's not required. So here is the example for number data type. So 102, 4567 and 567, this is the example for integer decimal number. And here 102 before adding capital O, and 876 before add small O, and 432 before add we have to using capital O. So capital O or small O we have to indicating the before the number, it is represented by octal integer. Do you understand, student? Yes. And the next one, 102 before we have to adding uppercase O and X. So the O and X representation, the given number is hexadecimal number. This is the one mark question. So the before the number we have to using the character like OX, small or capital. This is considered for hexadecimal integer number. And here 34L and 523L like is a long decimal integer. So L represent long decimal. So decimal don't need any identification. Okay. If the using number is long decimal, you have to using after the number L. After the number L. And floating point. A floating point data is represented by sequence of decimal digit that include decimal point. Like an exponent data constant decimal digital part, a decimal part, an exponent point followed by one or more digit. So here the floating point means it's a fractional value. So this is the floating point data like in number, floating number. Okay. So number we have to using integer, float and complex number. So this concept is a floating number. So here 123.34. So 0.34 like 10 power 2. Okay. So the point something we have to using the exponent data, capital letter E or small letter E. Capital letter E or small letter E. So the exponent data contains E, capital letter or small letter. And complex numbers made up of two floating point values, each one each for the real and another one is imaginary part. So the complex number is made up of two floating point value. Complex means we have to adding the two floating point number. So here you have to remind that complex number is made up of two floating point value, one each for the real and another one imaginary part. So already you know the floating point. This is the example for floating point number. And the next one, Boolean data type. So the Boolean data type have two values. First one true, otherwise false. Boolean data type can have two values like one value is true or value are false. So this is the concept. And string. So already you learned the string concept, like in the literal concept. String literal already you know, sequence of character is surrounded by quotes. Single or double or triple quotes we have to using. So like single letter means we have to using single or double quotes. Multi line means we have to using triple quotes. So here you have to see in string. String data can be enclosed with single quotes or double quotes or triple quotes. So here the get character data A. So A is a single character. So a single character means we have to using single quotes. Apostrophe. Did you understand, student? If you use single character, you have to using single or double quotes also it accept. And another one variable like string data, computer science. So the computer science is a sequence of character. COMPUTER. This is the sequence of character. Character or over character or a varisigal da vandhi nama string on solano. So in the mari number of character nama get pandrappa. Adha vandhi edhila da nama kudukano double quotes la da kudukano. Okay. And multi-line data abdingradhi enna na. Next line la varudhu paharunga. String data can be enclosed with a single quote or double quotes. This is the example. But here we have to creating another line. So this is single line. This is also single line. Here we have to using two line. So more than one line we have to using the string declaration. We have to using the triple quotes. Okay. So triple quotes vandhu two concept la kuttirukanga. Saringla. And the next one. So this is the concept for literal concept. This is the concept for literal like the tokens concept. So once again you have to recall in your book, like 5.7 tokens. It's a very very important 5-mark question. So token அப்படிங்கிறது என்ன சொல்லும், இன் பைத்தான் பிரேக் ஈச் லாஜிக்கல் லைன் இன்டு எ சீக்வன்ஸ் ஆஃப் எலமெண்டரி லெக்சிக்கல் காம்போனன்ட் லைக் டோக்கன். ஓகே, ஸோ த டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் டோக்கன் லைக் ஐடென்டிஃபையர், கீவேர்ட்ஸ், ஆப்ரேட்டர், டெலிமிட்டர்ஸ் அண்ட் லிட்டரல். ஸோ ஐடென்டிஃபையர் மீன்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டார்ட் பிகின் ஆல்பபெட்டிக்கல் லெட்டர் ஆர் அண்டர் ஸ்கோர், சரிங்களா. அண்ட் நம்பர் ஆல்சோ இட் அக்செப்ட், பட் இன் ஸ்டார்டிங் வி ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டார்ட் அல்பபெட்டிக்கல் லெட்டர் ஒன்லி. ஓகே, அட் த சேம் டைம் ஐடென்டிஃபையர் கேனாட் அலவுட் த கீவேர்ட், கீவேர்ட் ஆர் ஸ்பெஷல் கேரக்டர். ஸோ வாட் ஆர் த கீவேர்ட்ஸ், திஸ் இஸ் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஃபார் ஐடென்டிஃபையர் டிக்ளரேஷன். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லெட்டர் ஸ்மால் ஆர் கேபிட்டல் லெட்டர், பட் வி ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டார்டிங் அல்பபெட்டிக்கல் லெட்டர். ஓகே, ஸோ ஹியர் நம்பர் இஸ் நாட் அலோவிங், ஸ்பெஷல் கேரக்டர் நாட் அலோவிங், கண்டினியூ இஸ் த கீவேர்ட், ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஆல் this is also not allowing, so this is the invalid identifier. And keyword, so keyword is a special words or reserved word in Python. So some of keyword like continue, false, if, elif, except, like return, lambda, while, for. So these are the Python keywords. Just you have to refer in your book table 5.1. And operator, so there are 5 types of operators like arithmetical, relational, logical, assignment and conditional operator. So arithmetical like addition, subtraction, multiplication paathom, relation like less than equal, less than or equal like, and logical and or not. Assignment operator, assign the value. And conditional operator, what is the another name of conditional operator, like ternary operator. It is based on the condition true or false. So this is the example for conditional operator. And also you have to refer syntax. It's very important. Syntax is very important in our subject. And telemeters and literal. So there are 3 types of literal: numerical, string, boolean. So numerical abingirappa we have to using the number concept. First we have to using the data type integer, float or character. So like integer means we have to using the number, decimal, octal and hexadecimal. So string, already string and boolean. So numerical concept, integer, float or complex number, string concept, escape sequence and data type, number data type and string data type. Okay, so these are the concept in chapter 5, Python, variable and object. Okay, and here, so dear student, just you have to recall the chapter 5 Python concept. Who is created in Python? So in this lesson you have to learn this concept. So Python introduced like Hydro and Rosam. Okay, it was introduced or released in 1991. So programming in Python, interactive mode and script mode. Dear students, so this is your subject book. So just you have to see all the programs in your book. Okay, just you have to refer in your book. So who developed in Python? Hydro and Rosam. And the Python prompt like option A is the correct answer. And if you want to creating the Python new program, you have to use Ctrl plus N. So command begin option A as symbol. As like the symbol used to print more than one item in single line. Like comma. option C is the correct answer. Which of the following is not token? So tokens like identifier is the answer. Interpreter is the answer. And it's not a keyword. So keyword like operator is not a keyword. And comparative operator like which operator is also called a comparative operator? Relational operator is the comparative operator. Which of the following is not logical operator? Like assignment is the answer. Option T is the correct answer. And which operator is also called a conditional operator? Ternary operator is also called a conditional operator. Okay. So just you got to refer in your book, students. Okay, thank you.